As more and more people are working as freelancers, it's becoming more important to create your own online presence, to have your own portfolio website, a place where you can send people so that they can see what you do, see examples of what you have done, and also take action so that they can work with you. This is Jack from No Code MBA, and today we're going to talk about how you can build your own portfolio website in a way so that you get new leads using a tool called Card. We're going to talk about who this is for, the key features, how to create a portfolio website so that people take action, and also talk about a potential drawback and some alternatives if this is a problem for you. Before we jump in, be sure to subscribe to the channel so you can learn about no-code tools and also AI, and check out the description for a free guide to no-code tools and also more information about our premium courses. Let's start with the benefits of having a portfolio website. So a portfolio website is one where you can showcase what you offer and also a portfolio of your previous work. So it allows you to create the perfect experience for somebody who wants to learn more about working with you. And the other benefit is that you can lead people into taking the action that you want them to take. And we'll look at some examples later so you can truly understand this. But a lot of people get this wrong. They'll create a portfolio website but make it difficult for people to actually take action. Now, on your screen is a list of professions and industries that a portfolio website might benefit. Now, this includes photography or photographers, where you can highlight the photos that you've taken. And then the action people take is to get in touch or to book a free consultation with you. Another example is for web developers, who can showcase the websites that they have built and then again have a clear call to action, whether this is to get in touch with you or to have a free consultation. And then another example is for videographers. So you can showcase the videos that you have made, talk about the projects that you can do, and then even have packages where people can purchase video work from you. Now, with all that in mind, let's talk about what we believe is one of the most simple website builders, especially if you are creating a portfolio site. And that website builder is called Card. And we can see here on their website, it says build one-page sites for pretty much anything. Now, if you want to learn more about Card in depth, then go to our Card review and also look at how you can build a landing page using this website builder. We'll briefly talk about the pricing here because this is going to show you how affordable this is and also the key features that it offers. So there is a Pro Lite plan where it's $9 a year and a Pro Standard plan for $19 a year and a Pro Plus for $49 a year. Now, this pricing is obviously going to change, but if you compare it to some of the other website builders, then you'll see that it's very affordable. And just briefly, we can see some of the features here where you can get your custom domain URLs, no branding, high quality images, etc. Now, the one drawback that we're going to talk about later is that it's mainly set up for one-page websites, which might be important to you. We'll discuss that later on. And we're also going to discuss whether you need to have your own custom URL or if you can use a subdomain using Card. And we can see here that some of the features available are forms. So you can add contact and use sign up and embed forms from ActiveCampaign, MailChimp, etc., even Typeform. So when it comes to people taking action, you can connect this to email marketing services and also just regular contact forms too. Now, the best place to start is using their templates. You can customize these later, as we're going to see, but there is actually a section on portfolio websites. And it says here, simple designs to showcase your photos, art, graphics, and other visual content in fully functional Lightbox style image galleries. Now, even though you're building a portfolio website and they have portfolio templates, you might prefer to have a look at the form pages where it more focuses on the action that people are going to take, and also landing pages where it says make a product, app, service or something in between. So if you have a service where you are offering web design, then a landing page template might be better for you. But for now, we're just going to start with the portfolio templates and take a more of a visual effect. So if you're a photographer or a videographer, for example. And using one of these templates, we can see a very simple design here where I'm on the demo website for this. And it simply says hello at the top. You have the text here and then just image placeholders where you can put your own images in. And then at the bottom, it shows links to Instagram, Twitter, etc. So if you have social media accounts and you can use these types of buttons to link to those accounts. But what I think is missing on this template is the action that you want people to take. But you can also think of templates as like a starting point where you can add more stuff to it. And here, when we go to actually design our website using that template, it shows us some key features where we can add elements like text, images, and forms. You can undo previous action or redo preview animations if you have any. You can switch to mobile view and then publish site here. And I think the key thing to know at this stage is that this plus button allows us to add elements. And to do this, we can click anywhere on here and then say add element here. So what we might want to do is to add a list, to add buttons, to add links. And down here, you can see that the form is something that is on the pro plan. And we can start a free trial in order to play around with card. So now that I started the free trial, we see the form come up here. And you can think of creating this portfolio site as a way to showcase what you're doing. But like we said before, lead people into the action you want them to take. Because you can create the most beautiful portfolio website, but if people can't get in touch with you, then it's basically useless when it comes to bringing in new business. And then with this contact form, we can change it to sign up or contact. Now, sign up is where you can connect it to things like MailChimp. Now, if you're creating a portfolio website where people are getting in touch with you about custom work, then you'll probably just want the contact form. And then people can get in contact with you and you'll add your email address here so it goes to your email address. So just very briefly, what we can do is create our title here, which I think it's a good idea to talk about what you offer and the benefits of working with you so people get excited about coming onto your portfolio website. And then we add text so that we can talk about the problems people have and how we can solve those problems. We can showcase our work here. And then I recommend having a couple of sign-up forms or a couple of buttons so that people can get in contact with you. Now, another thing we can do is add a widget. So when we've got a widget, then we can have different types of embeddings here. And you can see we have Gumroad, Facebook Like, PayPal, and Typeform as the widgets that are here already. So if you want to do a Stripe checkout, or let's say Gumroad, because you have a product on offer, or you're selling videography packages or photography packages, then people can then click this link here, and then it's going to open up a checkout page from Gumroad, and people can buy your services directly from your portfolio website. And like I said, we can use Stripe checkout if we prefer, PayPal as well. And just going back to these elements that we can add different types of videos if we want. We can add links, icons, audio, galleries, tables, dividers, timers, etc. So you can think about how to craft the perfect portfolio page for you. And then with any of the blocks that we can choose, we can change the appearance. So we can change the color, the font, the size, the weight, etc. So we can be very specific with the type of branding that we want to introduce to our portfolio website. And what I recommend with Card is to have a look at the different templates, look at the demo first, and then choose the one that you think is best as your starting point. Let's talk about hosting and your domain name. So like we said before, you can either have a subdomain where it is yourportfolioname.card.co, or you can buy your own domain name and then point it to Card, which is very simple to do once you follow their step-by-step instructions. Now, the benefit of having your own domain name is that if you ever choose to use a different type of website builder, then you can simply point that domain to the new website builder. So let's say you move on to Squarespace after using Card, you simply follow their instructions, go inside your domain name account, and then point that domain name to Squarespace. And when it comes to hosting, Card will host this website for you, so you don't need to get a third-party hosting service. Now, the key feature to Card is that it keeps it very simple and it's all about one-page websites. Now, there are ways to introduce blogs into a Card website, but if you are thinking about blogging, if this is one thing that you want to focus on and it's important for your portfolio website, then I would recommend trying something like Wix or Squarespace. However, do look into the solutions that Card talks about when it comes to having a blog on your Card website. Once you have created the website and you are happy with it, then you can publish this. And what I highly recommend doing is sending the website to a few friends or to any experts that you know in web design and let them have a look for you. Also, ask them to check out the different links and forms that you have created so that you know that they are working properly. So as you can see, Card is a great tool for building these one-page websites, especially for things like portfolio websites. And even though you're building a portfolio website, do check out the different templates because it might suit what you're doing better than the portfolio templates. Now, if you want to learn more about building websites, apps, and automations using no-code tools, then do a couple of things. First, subscribe to this YouTube channel. And then go to nocode.mba and check out the courses that we have and also the free guide that we have. And if you want to stick around on YouTube, then look at the other videos that we've made on similar topics. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.